G'day scrappers, welcome to another scrap marathon. This one's going to be the mega marathon of all time. I think this is part one and it'll probably be about four or five parts to finally end this marathon. So the videos are going to be long, but yeah, that's probably why I'm going to split it up into four or five videos instead of having one ginormous 10-hour video or something like that. Would be absolutely crazy. So here we go. And the objective is to finally clear out this garage once and for all so I can get my main workshop back and I can get into the things as the weather is starting to warm up. I want to get into this garage and yeah, start doing other things as well. So I'm doing a lot of schools at the moment, so I'm really busy trying to catch up with all the stuff as it's coming in. You know, tubs and PCs and laptops, as soon as they come in, I'm trying to process. So I'll be doing that in between. I've got another couple of schools coming up in a few days. They're only small jobs, so if I get anything outrageous, I'll put it on video. But yeah, they're generally like two or three tubs of cables and mixed stuff, a few PCs, a few laptops, printers, monitors, keyboards, all that kind of stuff. Just a normal day-to-day e-waste. So here we go. I'm not really sure where to start. There's a lot of things in here that are being put inside because I want to keep it for another day. So it's just being able to scrap stuff out and organize other stuff where I want to put it. And so I've still got little bits around here. I've got all these wheelie bins full of cable and that's got circuit boards, but I've got wheelie bins full of cable and stuff that needs to be processed, all this stuff here. And then one of the things that I need to do is finally finish off all these PCs that are just sitting here and got some DVRs and stuff. Finish off this bin, still got surveillance stuff. And there's a couple of other bins with surveillance, but I need to get into this garage here or this shed and start scrapping stuff out of there, and then the stuff that I'm keeping, put it into the actual shed. So it's going to be a big job. Got things all over the place. Got some of these awesome vintage little modules here. These are actually they're military kind of systems grade. Well, they're certainly military grade boards. Nice components on there, but they're only small. So for once and for all, I've got to get through all this garage and work it out. So let's get to it. Enough talking, let's get scrapping. And I'm just going to organize myself to work out where I'm going to start. But obviously I've got to do all these cables and stuff to come in from school, smash up a lot of these power supplies that are sitting there, and yeah, just start getting into it. And hopefully by the end of this marathon, as I said, it might be four or five videos down the track, we're going to finally have a walkthrough workshop, workbench, things sorted out, and I can start getting into my gold recovery. And well, not getting into the gold recovery, but just sorting out a lot of pins. I've got a barrel, my standard barrel that I use as I'm throwing things out, and as you can see, it's full to the top, overflowing. And this is all just gold pins and the stuff that needs to be sorted into their categories. And then I can finally get into doing some. I've got a lot of boards backed up that need to be depopulated with the air hammer. Just got so many things. I've got boxes of oddball components, a lot of multiples. So what I'll probably do is I'll probably scrap one out on video and then you know, finish the whole lot off and go on to the next thing. I've still got PCs, little PCs inside the garage. It's crazy. Anyway, let's make a start and see how we go with this scrap marathon. As I said, it's the mega marathon of all time. And yeah, so I think for now, what I'll be doing is, yeah, I'm just going to process these three tubs here to get them out the way. I need these tubs because I've got a couple of school pickups to do in a couple of days. So just need these tubs free, and I'll just smash up these little power supplies, power packs, and just to get rid of this crate. So I think this one's as good as any. And this school, actually, it's just a little primary school, and what they do is they keep their e-waste until the kids have got nothing to do, and they have their own scrap sessions. They call it tinkering, their tinkering session. And they just let the kids tinker around with e-waste, scrap stuff out, you name it, they've scrapped it out. So yeah, a lot of this is just very messy stuff and just loose. This one's mostly cables, but some of the things I've told them not to scrap out because it's a bit, it's not really good for kids to be scrapping out, like monitors. They actually open up the whole monitor right in, and they get to the little fluorescent tubes which contain mercury. And when I was loading this into the van, I noticed some of those mercury tubes were broken and they were just mixed in. And so I told them, you know, don't scrap them out at all, because yeah, it's no good for anyone, let alone kids, because kids have got very thin skin. And so even the smallest trace of mercury touching their skin, they'll absorb that into their body straight away. And well, as you know, with all heavy metals, you can't actually remove it from your body once you've got it in there. So they're going to have that in there for the rest of their lives. It's not something that they should be playing with. Scrapping out PCs and stuff, that's fine, but just, yeah, I just told them don't bust into any kind of monitors or any screens, LCD screens. Yeah, but yeah, let's just clean up these tubs. There's one of their partially scrapped out DVDs. They obviously, in a lot of things that I've already done, they don't even take out the screws. They try and bust everything open. Probably not the right way to go about it if they don't really even know what to expect when they get into it. So, yeah, bit weird. This was stuff was all loose in the van, because they had everything in wheelie bins, so I just emptied the bins out into the van or into these tubs as they came. But yeah, all this kind of work is, you know, when it comes to small business, this is very time-consuming and reasonably low value. You know, it's got to be done, because what else do you do with it? You know, the larger recyclers, they'll put a lot of this. They usually sell, they don't process their cords. They just sell their cords as they are. They get less value, but obviously it's just not worth paying someone X amount per hour to do all this. And then I do obviously the little bit extra by cleaning up the plugs, taking out the little steel prongs, so it just gives less weight when I put it in storage. And so that's going to be for gold recovery. And yeah, schools get a lot of these kind of headphones. Just process them for the wire, and but yeah, it's a very tedious thing. And because I know all these cords are just basic stuff, don't relate to anything that I need, I can just process as I go straight away. So I usually cut off the USB as much as possible to keep as much on the actual cable to get the weight, and I just keep that for a tiny gold recovery. Just check the power supply. So this is a HP power supply. So I'll put that aside and see if I can match it up to a laptop that I might need a power supply for before I process it. The other one, that's another HP. So I'll keep that. Yeah. Gosh. This is off some sort of, this is like a pressure gauge or something. But there's a nice piece of copper in there and copper wire running all the way through this by the looks. But yeah, I'll just get this bit of copper. Throw the rest into wire rather than bothering with it. But yeah, it's a very tedious job. And when you've got a lot of stuff you want to get through, like big stuff, this stuff feels like it takes forever. And it kind of does. But if I just process as I go as best I can, HDMI plugs, I don't even bother going for these for gold recovery because they're just too hard to get into for what it's worth. Yeah. So as I go, I'll probably get more ideas for this marathon. I'm just going to need the first day here to go through those bins and process some of the junk. Some will say it's all junk. Well, it kind of is. Even these, the VGA plugs. They can be okay for gold recovery. For some of you, if you're selling your plugs to like board sort or something like that, you don't remove these pins because you're just giving up weight. And you know, they're mostly steel, and so they buy them complete. I'm only doing this because this is my personal, goes in my personal stockpile, so I want it as light as possible, so I'm not carrying 100 kilo tubs around, because all I want is just those little pins. Sometimes when cable gets tangled up like that, I know I'm only going to cut it. I just cut what I can off it, and eventually that reduces the tangle. Yeah. So I think I'll get through this cable and we'll see what's actually inside it, and we'll go into the hopefully something a bit more interesting in there. Well, that was a bit boring. I just cleared off this whole tub just to get it out of the way. It was just rubbish and cords. The only thing left in there was this thing that looks like they've tried to scrap out. They've only got the outside of it out. They couldn't get to the screws inside or something. So I'll just scrap this out and we'll go on to the next thing, which will probably be the power plugs, just to get them out the way. All right, so I'm not really sure what it is. It's got internet, HDMI, USB. It's hard to tell once they've removed the whole outside cover, but it doesn't matter. I'll just get rid of this. We can get on to the next thing. I can't get... There must be a screw here. I think the reason why they couldn't get into it was it's got Torx screws. Not that I think that they use screws anyway, but yeah, it was just Torx screws to get in. And the rest is Phillips. Yeah, just a basic board really. Looks like a power supply. But at this stage, doesn't really matter. It's just what it is a matter of is just getting rid of things. Oh no, it's a hard drive in here. I should have known. There we go. Where is it? 1 terabyte. Pretty standard. Yep, pretty basic. I'll probably just take these crystals and leave the rest on as a mid-grade board. Well, that's that out the way too. Awesome. Chicken's having a little look around. The next thing I'm going to do are these things here. So I'm going to just smash these up. They're building up. Got a whole crate of them here. Just want to get the little bit of brass outside and get rid of the plastic. Okay. So, got the safety glasses on. Want to crack these up. And I'll I'll clean the rest up on the bench. Nice long black one. Oh. Gosh, this plastic was really brittle. But look at that, you know, it's worth it, you know, quite a bit of brass, got some, you know, got your wire. All right, well, I've got my little mess here, got my junk plastic. So now this is the therapeutic part, where I just chill out and clean all these bits off, clean the wire off the brass. We got our little brass piece here. Just keep doing that. A few of these needs to be just they've just got little things stuck to them, so nice and easy. There we go, just got a little bit of a circuit board there we can pry off. Might just okay. So yeah, I mean, they're not big value things, but I pick them up whenever I see them in street scrapping. And you know, brass, it adds up, you know, and it's worth, you know, reasonably good money, so why not pick it up? And also you get a bit of wire there, so almost, you know, about half the price of the brass. But for any, you know, basic scrappers, if you've got plenty of time, in this case there's a little screw here which 9 times out of 10 will be steel. Just get my little magnet. Yeah, see, it's steel, and I don't want to mix this in with my brass just in case the scrapyard runs a magnet over brass when I take it in. And you know, if they start picking up bits of steel, then they can always downgrade your brass, and well, that's not what we want. I don't try and sneak in junk in things like brass or copper. Just play fair. Yeah. But this is really good stuff to do when you've got real downtime. And you just don't want to do heavy scrapping. So I don't mind continuing to pick up these things. I never let pass them by, because yeah, it's end of the day, it all adds up, and it's good money. And who doesn't like brass? So with this plastic and stuff, that's just, well, it's just got to go to rubbish. Nothing much you can do about it. No one wants it to recycle it here anyway. So what do? But it's a very common thing for scrappers to come across these power sort of packs. So yeah, I highly recommend picking them up. And you'll see at the end we'll have quite a bit of wire. I mean, it's, you know, it's not going to change your life, but hey, you don't get 100 kilos of wire until you start with 1 kilo, and you don't get 1 kilo until you start with 1 gram. It's just one of those things that you keep building up until you've got enough to make it worthwhile taking it to the scrapyard. But I hope this video gets a bit more exciting as it goes. We'll see how it goes. We can't expect miracles. We're only scrappers. But I notice a lot of people comment that they watch scrapping videos like this at the same time that they're scrapping themselves. And that's a pretty good idea. Because a lot of times when you're scrapping, or when we're scrapping, we're doing it on our own, and you know, sure, you can have a bit of music going to motivate you a bit more, but if you enjoy talking scrap and listening to people talk scrap, or just have something different to look at, it's a good idea. If you've got a monitor nearby where you can flick on YouTube, it's just a big transformer, and watch scrapping videos as you go, and at the same time, you know, not just my videos, but other scrappers' videos, and yeah, at the same time, you're, you know, supporting people's channels, supporting the scrap industry, you know, because there's quite a few scrappers on YouTube now, and these days we don't make much on YouTube. It's not like it probably was a few years ago. So yeah, it, you know, not just my videos, but you know, other scrappers videos, if you can, if you don't mind running, like watching the ads that roll through, it's not a lot, but it does help scrappers out, to encourage them to make more videos. And especially if you're new to scrapping, don't just rush through the videos. Watch people's stuff and listen to what they've got to say. They're only trying to pass on good information. And yeah, if you let their ads roll, you know, it helps them out. And you know, so you're kind of giving back a little bit at the same time as getting some information from them, you know. So I don't know, I'm waffling on a bit, but anyway, so I'll just continue here and finish off this little stack, and we'll see what we end up with. Good handful of brass there. Nice insulated wire. Put that in our little tub. All right, well, I'm going to scrap out this PC to give me a empty cavity for scrap steel bits. My little cable barrel here is filling up, so this is normally my insulated copper wire barrel that I take to the scrapyard. I recently emptied it, so I've just thrown in some scrap mid-grade boards that I recently bought. Just to keep them out of the rain, I just throw them into a bin like this to, until I get a chance to work out which ones I depopulate and which ones I just throw into to on-sell. So I'm just going to do this bin off camera and process the boards how I like to do it. It's a bit of secret scrapper business. Yeah, just to give me this empty wheelie bin, and that way I can empty my tub of cable and get on to scrapping out this PC. There's not much to this one. This was just one that I picked up off the street. It still has a hard drive in there though, so yeah. And then we'll just continue on, and I think the next step will be to start removing some of the things that I'm keeping, like these barrels here are CPUs. So this one's got black fiber CPUs, I've got green fiber and other kinds of chips, so I'm going to put all those things into an area temporarily, so I can just keep getting into this garage and start processing it. But I've got a feeling a lot of stuff here is things that I've sort of put aside to keep, so it's just trying to work out where I can put everything. So I'll just get onto that and get onto this PC, and then yeah, also because I really want to get it into this shed and start processing some of the stuff,
I'm going to probably just do a straight run of PCs for a while and just get this out the way. And this tub here is the one that's going to take a long time. And I've got to do it over time because most of it, apart from the circuit board inside, it's a lot of plastic rubbish. And so if I scrapped everything in here in one go, I would actually create two wheelie bins of plastic rubbish. So I've got to kind of get rid of it as I'm sort of scrapping it in batches. And yeah, and I want to do a bunch of these different set-top boxes. The Foxtel, the cable television type of boxes. So there's so many different, you know, there's four, looks like five different ones just here. And I've got a few others, so I might do a little stint on them. And yeah, all right, let's go.
Okay, so I made the decision to make a start on this pile here that's blocking off the shed. So I can't really do a lot of stuff in the garage until I start emptying most of the shed. That way I can put all the things that I'm keeping into the shed. And that way it'll make room for me to be able to clean out the garage. So this is my first mission, and I've actually got a van with some scrap metal in there. So I'll be able to throw a bit of this into the van and take it to the scrapyard straight away, so too much doesn't stack up. So I'm going to start off with these 10 DVRs that are sitting down the bottom here. They've been here for ages, sitting out in the rain. They're no good. I've got a lot of hard drives out of these, and there's still good hard drives in there, like 2 terabyte, sometimes even 4 terabyte hard drives. And so I've been selling a few of the hard drives, so I've made a bit of money out of them. And then, yeah, the rest of these PCs. So I'm just going to take away these 10 first. And then, yeah, this is what I've got to do at this first stage of the video, is just to get rid of this old stockpile of PCs and stuff. And then probably even get into that bin as well and give me that bin to play with. But I can't even remember what's inside the garage. I know right as soon as I open the door, it's going to be a desk that I picked up. I wouldn't mind getting that desk and putting it inside. I was going to restore it, give it a polish and stuff, but I'll do that another time. Okay, so let's get on to this, eh? So I've been wanting to scrap this one out for a while. It's American Dynamics. Intellex LT. It's, I can't remember, it's kind of like in the same kind of genre of a DVR kind of thing, but it's probably, you know, more like a PC than anything in some ways. It's going to have a motherboard. It looks like it's got 3 cards in there, power supply. So yeah, I'll just get into this one first, get it out the way. It's a nice big box, so I can use this for putting some scrap metal inside. Okay, been wanting to have a look what's inside this. Okay, so yeah, very much like a PC, only one card here. Looks like a nice card though. Just a little motherboard, hard drive. It's probably going to be a pretty good hard drive. And these kind of things have the video surveillance type hard drives. They're designed to run like 24 hours a day, you know, constantly. So a little bit different than a regular PC hard drive. And yeah, well, it's only a 500 gig, so no real good to me. But what is it, enterprise class HDD durability, so it would be a good quality one, you know. I get much bigger. 500 gigabytes is not much these days. You want at least 2 terabytes, and I'll get a lot of them from the other DVRs that I scrap out today. So yeah, certainly got my work cut out for me, but these kind of things, I have a bit of, you know, it's a bit of fun as well as work, so it's not really hard work for me, and I enjoy doing it. So it's always interesting to see what kind of CPU I get out, and cards, and even hard drives. I get excited when I get a 4 terabyte hard drive out of the systems. As far as slot cards is concerned, this is, look at the fingers. They the smallest. These would have to be the smallest set of fingers for a slot card that I've ever seen. But the actual board itself, it looks like a really high-end board. And yeah, there's a BGA under there. But yeah, this will just go as a slot card for me. But you can see the crystal oscillators here. They're nice sized, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4 crystal oscillators just on one card. So they're the only things I'll probably keep, and the rest, it'll just go as a slot card. It's a good weight, so yeah, I'm happy with that. Maybe I should get down a bit, hey. And take my motherboard here. Now we've got one RAM. I dare say it wouldn't be much. Oh no, it's a 2 gigabyte DDR3, so it's got some sale value for me. As I've mentioned before, I've got buyers for various things. Got a CPU buyer, I've got a couple of RAM buyers that pay pretty good price. So the CPU looks like it should be a good one. No, it's just a regular Pentium. It's not a it's a new style, but an older version of a, it's not a i3 or anything like that, just a regular. They don't really sell well here in Australia anyway. Unless it's, these days, even i3s don't sell that good anymore. It's mostly, you know, there are a few versions of i3 that still hold some good value, but it's mostly either i5s, and obviously anything i7 is awesome. Nice little motherboard, only small. It's a, it's got the little blue connectors, USB 3. So, I've mentioned before, with motherboards, when you got the blue USB 3 connectors, they're usually a good motherboard. There will be PC repairers and restorers that, or builders that will want these. Anything with the USB 3 ports is a good start. So here we've got a a copper stacker heatsink. So that's nice. And so it looks like a big chunk of copper. It might be a goblet style. All right, it's a solid one. So that's really nice. So about 95% of the weight of this heatsink is in the copper. And I've never seen one that's so big with these small fins, and it actually pops out, sticks out. So there's a really good slab of copper here. It's probably about 97% copper to aluminium. Just to prepare it, I like to remove these plastic clips just so they're not in the way when with these ones. It's got this mounted piece of steel here, so this one, I've got to cut through that steel to be able to remove that, and also obviously the aluminium. But the aluminium, once I take this out, it's still extruded aluminium, so it's still good quality alloy. And beautiful copper stacker, and that's really heavy, although there is some steel here, but a good value copper out of that. So just get my power supply out, process this. There you go, power supply ready for sale. Clean up this wire. Nice and easy, you know. Sometimes I think to myself, well, that was so easy. Why didn't I just do it in the first place rather than stacking them? But it's not as simple as that, because there has never been a time when I haven't been overloaded with e-waste. And the minute I, you know, think I'm going to start to get into old stuff like this that's hanging around, I'll get 3 or 4 pickups in the week or something crazy where it just sets me back. Because like one pickup can take 3 days to process. So if I do three pickups in 1 week, usually it's about 2 weeks worth of work. So as the weeks go on, it just gets more and more carried away. Just taking these little bits of brass. Yeah, it's and because I like to scrap a bit hobby style. So I like to, you know, tinker and fiddle with things and do it slowly. It can set me back even more. But we just make do. Okay, well, that was the American Dynamics DVR. And yeah, it wasn't bad. And just a little motherboard, not much value as scrap. So this is what I mean when they got the USB 3. If you've got a motherboard buyer, or you know where to, most other countries, pretty easy to sell these on eBay. Yeah, reasonably easy to sell here too, but just low value. And I just don't have the space to keep everything. So things like 2 gig and above RAM, easy for me to sell. And, you know, I can have a whole box built up, and, you know, a big box can be $3,000 or $4,000 worth of RAM, and so it's just a lot easier for me to sell the better things. Easy to post out CPUs, just put it in a rigid disk mailer, and nice and safe, easy to ship. Whereas motherboards and that, you've got to start wrapping them, packing them, and then Yeah, always risk that there's something wrong, a capacitor is blown or something's wrong with it, and then they return it and you lose money on shipping. And yeah, so, but over the years I've gotten quite a few buyers where I don't have to worry about selling on eBay that much. Mostly I sell power supply units on eBay from servers. But having said that, I've been stocking up power supplies for quite a while now, and I haven't sold on eBay for over a year, so we've got to catch up on that too. All right, okay, one of these March DVRs. Done a lot of these over time. You've already seen quite a few of these done. Yeah, quite nice actually. The boards are huge and really nicely populated. Two hard drives, there are 2 terabyte hard drives, and as you can see, the hard drives are the video 3.5 hard drives, so they're just a little bit better for constant recording, and so I like them, and you know, they're fine to use in PCs as well. Just get rid of some of these cables. It's like the battery pack here. When I first done these and I saw this and I thought, wow, these are like capacitors or something, but no, they're just they're batteries. And yeah, battery packs, they're no real good for anything else really. Just send them off to recycling somewhere. Okay, so just get these hard drive caddies out, and there's quite a lot of aluminium here, so these are just, you know, nice aluminium. Just keep them like that for now, and just for a little bit extra protection. So yeah, some of these systems come with 2 2-terabytes, and some come with 1 4-terabyte. We'll just get that aluminium. Nice little caddies. No real good for any other system apart from what there is. All right. Screws on the side. I need to upgrade some of my tools. My side cutters are getting a bit blunt, and the drill bit is starting to wear out, so a lot of the just spins on a lot of screws. It's a double-sided drill bit, so I get extra value, you know. This one's completely, it's got a point on it. So they're not much, they're only about $7 or something. And they last me almost a year. Just a little power board. Oh, there goes a little spider. This is like a little slot card, and there's a little backplane board there, but only shiny, very shiny gold fingers, so not very good for gold recovery. Better off just to sell it as a slot card. Okay, now I just got to remove these risers, because they're also like little screws. These are just aluminium. Sometimes they can be brass, and most of the time they're steel, but these are just aluminium. Still, we throw it in, two aluminium. Keep knocking the tripod on the camera. Something doesn't want to give. So that's just a riser board, just low grade here. But as you can see, it's a really nice board. It's got a bit of everything. It's even got gold fingers, and they're quite good gold fingers. Obviously, you know, a mixture of flat packs and BGAs in between. You know, crystal oscillators, tantalum capacitors. It's got a nice mix of everything, you know. MLCCs. And look at these pins on there, really good. Look in there, it's a bit dirty because this one was sitting right on the ground. But these gold pins here are beautiful. I definitely want those gold pins before I do anything else with the board. And sometimes boards like this, you know, I end up almost depopulating the whole thing instead of selling it. So I just break off this whole set of pins and just put it with pins for now. And yeah, it'll bit of work to get them out, but I think well worth it for gold recovery. And so it almost is unnoticeable that you removed it, because it removes quite clean and with these gold fingers. So I just like to do that, you know, straight away, because they're coming off anyway. So there we go, a couple of nice fingers. And as you can see, the rust is sort of, that's just surface rust come off something else, because heavy rains just get soaked. And the other side, yeah, a lot of the rust came on this board. But this board is actually awesome in itself. It's got BGAs all over it, some flat packs and ICs, more tantalums. You know, but, you know, this would go as a telecom grade board, simply because it's got no rubbish. Even though we've taken off the gold fingers, and we've probably helped the value of the board by removing the pins, because even though they're really nice gold pins, they're still quite heavy for the price that we get for the board. But yeah, so yeah, this would go as a telecom board, especially with this board here. It's a really nice high-end part. But I've got a few of them to do today, so I'll just put them aside, and I'll pick off a few things. and I probably, you know, when I start picking off things, if I pick up enough things, I'll actually bring this down from telecom grade right down to mid grade, so about a quarter of the value, you know. And you know, but I'd still leave chips on, like this not very good BGA here, and you know, the flat packs and stuff. And I might, if I take out these BGAs and leave the main ICs and stuff, and then take the tantalum capacitors, some MLCCs, a little crystal oscillator there, and then that'll bring it down to a mid-grade. But when I do that because I just want the gold recovery stuff, and I'm prepared to sacrifice the value for now. Okay, it's just really this is like a nothing board. It's got no IC chips on it, so you know, it doesn't really even go as a low grade because there's nothing on it. All right, so that's that. I don't bother cleaning out this cavity because it is mostly aluminium, but it's got a lot of iron on it. Could you sell it as irony aluminium? But I just don't have the space for irony aluminium stuff at the moment. That's that. All right, well, 8 more to go. Well, that's 6 down. 4 of these DVRs to go. This is another oddball one. Got 4 of these. Okay. So these are the ones that I was looking for. The hard drive is undone from underneath, so I've already done that. Look at that. 4 terabytes. 4 terabyte, 64 meg cache, and as you can see, it's WD Purple surveillance hard drive. So these are really good for, you know, obviously they're for surveillance because they can run 24 hours a day around the clock. So they're just a little bit different, obviously, but still can be used as a PC hard drive. Awesome. If I ever get a surveillance system, maybe at the next place, I'll, you know, obviously I keep these 4 terabytes to give me extra memory. So really not much to these, but obviously a nice little 4 terabyte hard drive. So that in itself is just good value. Long story, obviously we've been through all this. I can't actually sell these DVRs because they were part of the destruction thing, so that's fine, doesn't bother me. I'm happy just to get the hard drives and be done with it. So I'll just get this power supply out. Just got one more screw here. Right, nice little power supplies. Because I've done so many of these, I've kept a lot of these. I've got enough in case I want to build up something with very small power supply units. They're tiny little deltas. Get this main one done straight away. Just clean up the wire. Every one that I've done, what I've done 6, you know, I clean the wire as I go, so to not end up with a ton of wire to process on top of what I've already got, barrels of it. So when I call these done, they're completely done. The wire's processed, everything's done. I've got to look up how to demagnetize these screw bits because end up having to handle every one. Okay, so average little kind of motherboard. Obviously got to remove the battery, but there are some nice BGAs around the main BGAs. Might take off. It's pretty much just a mid-grade board. These gold pins, again, because they're very bright and shiny, they're not as good as others, so I don't even bother taking these ones off. You know, I can, yeah, I suppose it all adds up, but yeah, I can just see that they're not the highest of quality, but I might end up doing it anyway. But yeah, so not a bad board, not a great deal of weight to it. So because it's just going to be a mid-grade, it's technically almost like a little motherboard, but I'll just throw it in mid-grade and take off a couple of the little BGAs. And that's it. So that's as quick as it gets. The main value here, because I've got to scrap them out, is the 4 terabyte hard drives. They're brand new. These systems are brand new. I took these out of boxes when I got them, out of all the packaging and stuff. Got rid of that a long time ago. So, beautiful. Can't complain for 4 terabyte hard drive, even just for data storage. They're great, but you know, I've got a few in data storage. I don't have much stuff to store. So I've got 3 more of these to go, and then 1 more of something else, and go on to some PCs probably. Okay, down to the last one. That's going to be 10 for the day so far. This is one of the Neo DVRs. Just open her up. Okay, well, the board's a little bit better on this one than the last one. The hard drive, it's only a 1 terabyte, so that's a bit of a step down. So that will do. All right, power supply. Special, that one. Well, unbelievable. I mean, it's not much, really. It's not much work to do 10 DVRs, and it drives me crazy because after I do them, I think, why didn't I do these 6 months ago, you know? But yeah, as I keep saying, it's just that there's so many things always come in front of it, and it's easy to set and forget. They become part of the furniture, and you don't even notice them after a while. You just walk past them all the time, and you know, the only time you notice them is when I think of trying to get into the shed. Then I think, oh gosh, I mean, it would have been easy just to move everything and get into the shed, but that doesn't achieve anything, you know. I do that quite often because I'm left with no choice. But it just doesn't get me anywhere because you move things, okay, and that takes work in itself, and then you just end up with you still got the stuff sitting there. So for once and for all, we're going to do this garage marathon and really get the job done and be done with it. I want to get into some more hobby things for myself, not so much just business. I want to have a bit of fun. So, okay. Yeah. We've got this, the back sort of plain board as well, even though they're not, there's really no real value. Can probably get away with throwing them into a low grade board.
a little bit better than, well, it's almost three times better than scrap steel. So yeah, so that's actually quite a good board. You know, got BGAs, got a really nice BGA here. Some ICs, flat packs. You know, it's still technically only a mid-grade board, but, you know, I can bring it down to mid-grade board rather than trying to get any higher. You know, it's technically, it's like a mid to high-grade board, but we don't have a grade for high-grade anymore. I pay higher prices for mid, and see, this is just pretty much junk. You know, base metal recovery, low grade. All right, well, I'll just get my little hard drive. Data cable, get okay money for data cable these days. Just got to remove the plugs, but obviously I put these in for gold recovery. All right, well, that's that. That's 10 DVRs. Okay, well, Here's my 10 DVRs, and they're going to go into this van full of scrap steel. So I'm just going to throw them in pretty much anywhere they can go. Just most of this is remnants of street scrapping. You can see the big compressor there. I took out the motor, so yeah, the rest, obviously you don't want the petrol motor. Yeah, so I've got rid of that, and I've kept the motor for another day when I build up enough to take. Some of these bottom, the last few DVRs have got quite a bit of junk inside. Just fill them up. Screws and so maybe in a day or so I might go take this into the scrapyard. There we go. Okay, I've got a stack of 12 PCs from the back. Most of them are sort of like a smaller form factor, the IBM Think Centers. They're actually very heavy little things, so they're going to have hard drives and just good weight overall, even for scrap steel. And so yeah, I'll just make a start. I'm just going to get all these out the way, and that might get pretty close to filling up the van with the scrap steel anyway. And yeah, well, then we've probably still got about another 40 PCs to clear that area off. So yeah, a lot of the work's mostly going to be off camera. Obviously you don't want to see me scrap 40 PCs. All right, just a school Dell. Got seven of these and three ThinkPads.
in this batch anyway. The good thing about these Dells is they are pretty good value. They're quite heavy for the size, you know, and straight away, like, we got a copper aluminium radiator that we can sell, so obviously goes better than just aluminium, at least twice the price, usually closer to three times the price. Just for anyone that's selling boards to me, you know, boards like this where they've just got your adapters and stuff, there's no IC chips or anything like that. This is just low grade. Even though it's green both sides, it's not a mid-grade or a peripheral board. It's just a low-grade board because it's only base metal recovery. And so I get a lot of these thrown into mid-grade boards, and they're really not mid-grade boards. You know, if there's one in a larger batch, then sure, you don't notice, you know, one or two, I let them through, but yeah, when there's quite a few, it's just downgrades the batch, so you've really got to take them out, save me taking them out anyway. So it's probably going to rain soon, within a couple of hours. So I want to get at least these PCs out the way and onto drag another batch out of that back area, so I keep it out of the rain, so they're not soaking wet before I scrap them. Okay, so yeah, these are pretty straightforward. Because I've got multiples of the same thing, after you do the first one, it just gets easier and easier because you've got a system going. So, you know, very small PC, but and quite small power supply units, but they're so heavy, they really pack a punch. And so that's good value for me. That's what we want. It's all about weight when you're selling bits for just a scrap. Okay. Yeah. This blade, Phillips, is starting to get blunt, and so unless you're pushing down, it slips. Spins around. Very common school PCs are very dusty. A lot of schools are quite very dusty for some reason. These are only 1 gigabyte, so just a scrap. Regular Pentium CPU, just goes straight motherboards. I like to clean the backs of my CPUs, that way when I've got a big batch of them, it's not just all the paste all over the place, gets all over your hands, so I like to clean them. That's it. So with these SATA type DVDs, I don't bother getting the tiny little board out for the time. All right, well, that's that. And just got to clean up some of this wire. I used to just throw this data cable, the ribbon, this kind of cable anyway, straight into low grade, but because the new yard that I go to, they have a separate category for data now, and It's only about 50% less than regular insulated wire, so I get about 50% more by just cutting off the plugs and selling it separately. And well, I take off these plugs anyway because I want them for gold recovery, obviously. So I just the only real difference is that I just need a separate bin just for data cable. All right. I don't have any other bits of scrap metal. I've got rid of it all, so that'll do. Okay, I'll get through another six of these, and then do a think center. Right, onto these IBM think centers. I like these ones, they're nice and compact. Oh, there's a little gecko. You gotta get out of there, mate. It's not much good for our shelter anymore. I try and pick them up and I put them in a sort of like a safe area so the chickens don't get to it or the local cats. But he probably thinks he's in attack mode now. So he's under the motherboard. There's a little riser card with gold fingers. Yeah. Well, these ones, a lot of the little Dells that I got, the first couple didn't have a hard drive, but the rest did. And this one does, and so that's good. The more stuff in them when I'm scrapping them out, the better, I suppose. Okay. He's out. I got him. Okay, he's nice and safe now. I put him under some little bits of logs. So you don't want to grab them by the tail because then they drop their tail. So yeah, it's really weird when you, yeah, if you pick them up and you grab them by the tail and oh, the tail's still there, but he's gone. So try to let them fall into your hands, and that way they keep their tail and they don't have to grow another one. But it's a pretty interesting defense mechanism. Say when a bird grabs them, they're out of there. The bird takes the tail, gets a little feed. But it's amazing how nature does things like that. It's crazy. Really nice little chunky power supply units, all good value. All right, these are pretty good heat sinks as well. As you can see, it's mostly aluminium, but this central part here, it's quite thick and chunky. That's actually tinned copper. So again, this goes as a copper aluminium radiator, like the ones with the piece of copper that you can see. You only need to sort of scuff into it and you'll see the red of the copper underneath this tin plating. So this central part, and it's probably the heaviest part of the whole lot. tin copper. It makes a, you know, pretty big difference, three times the value. You build up a wheelie bin full of them and certainly adds up. All right, just one ram. It's like a 512 just for scrap. These motherboards are mounted on a steel plate. But yeah, as I said, good value, these little PCs, because they're so heavy and condensed with good stuff and easy to scrap. Bracket here, aluminium. Just remove the steel if we can. Yeah. Got a little bit. A little bit stuck in there. Ah. I'll clean that up later. There we have it. Nice little motherboard. Send off. And yeah, and the other thing here, because it's got the old school circuit board. These are the ones I always scrap out. There we go. So I'm mostly after the gold pins later on. I keep these boards, then I'll just depopulate the whole thing. Aside from a bit of low-grade ribbon wire, I'll just take the brass out. That's all I do. All right. Well, that's the IBM, and that's 12 PCs down. So I'm just going to load these into the van.
12 PCs all scrapped out. Yay. Load them into the van, and look at this. Got some nice empty space here. It's getting there, guys. Okay. So it looks like I'll be going to the scrapyard tomorrow morning, or sometime tomorrow. Still not, it's not going to be a full load or anything, but it'll do. Awesome. Yep, I'll see if I can scrap out a couple more things before I go. But that'll do. That would have taken up quite a big space here anyway. And then the next batch of PCs I do, it'll go all right. All right. Looking forward to getting into more of this. Hey. Okay. chicken's been busy helping me scrap. So here we go. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 24, 26, 28, 30, 37 PCs to go, and that'll be it. And then I'll get into this shed and start making a little bit of room, or just to see what's in there. But what I'll probably do next is start scrapping out some of these different Foxtel cable boxes that I've got. I've got a whole bunch built up, different models, different brands, or same brand I think, but they're all pretty much Foxtel. But yeah, it'd be interesting to see what's in all different ones. All right, well, my copper box, little bits of copper and stuff that I pick out, starting to build up. Got to empty that. All right, let's go to the scrapyard. I might scrap a couple of things out first, and then we'll head to the scrapyard.
Okay, well, I'm back from the scrapyard, and I had 440 kilos of pressing steel. Admittedly, you know, there's quite a bit of rubbish in there as well, but only 7 cents a kilo. And so for that batch was $30.80. So not a great deal of money for 440, almost half a ton. And it looks like the prices are just going to go lower and lower for the time being. And yeah, so that's interesting. And especially heading towards Christmas, it'll probably go, traditionally all metals go down a little bit. It looks like it's probably not going to be worth picking up scrap steel in street scrapping. All I'll do is, because I still accumulate a lot of scrap steel from scrapping out PCs and stuff like that, that's enough for me. It's just like my rubbish rather than trying to pick it up to make money out of. But it's still okay to get paid for something that's really just rubbish for me. But yeah, when I go out street scrapping, I'm just not going to pick up any more scrap steel because it's just not worth it. I recently went street scrapping, and it was that day when I picked up the motors, a lawnmower motor and a lawnmower and a compressor, and one of them leaked oil all over inside the van. So, you know, it took me half an hour to clean up all the oil out of the van. So really messy for considering the money that I got for them. So I'm just going to, in the next few weeks, there's only probably 3 or 4 weeks of street scrapping left before Christmas. Might be a little bit longer, but I'm just going to go strictly e-waste. You know, I just want to do it for fun, and you know, I've been picking up scrap steel just because to add a little bit of extra money. But yeah, for the extra work, unloading the van and loading the scrap steel back up, and yeah, unless I find something really heavy, I won't worry about it. But okay, so I've just got to go and do a e-waste pickup at a school. So I've just got to put my uniform on and get out there. So I'll just go and do that job, and then we'll continue with this scrap marathon. It'll be interesting to see what I get from this little school. It's only a small school, so I don't expect a great deal. But we'll take what we can get. Okay, well, I'm back from the little e-waste pickup from a school. It wasn't bad pickup. But this is one of the reasons why I get a build-up of stuff in the garage and all that, because things keep coming in, and as well as street scrapping, I just don't get a chance to do everything. So, you know, now I've spent a couple of hours going to do the school pickup, and so it, yeah, so it's easy to stockpile stuff and just let it get, you know, carried away. But anyway, I'm back, and that's the main thing. I can get onto a bit of this work. I got a lot of these toner cartridges, and they're pretty good because especially the HP ones, like I know the 55A, these can sell pretty good, and I got quite a lot of them. And you know, if you know, probably get $40 or $50 each for them, and sometimes more, sometimes $70, $80. It just depends on the type of on the actual model. You know, like magenta, the colored ones are a little bit harder to sell, but the black ones, gosh, they sell really, really, really well. Easy to sell. So yeah, it looks like mostly black. So that's a bit of a bonus. Got some UPSs here, and more of these Cisco aero nets. These older ones are pretty good. They got good, actually this is the newer one. These aren't so good because they don't have much of a circuit boards in there, but I like these older ones. Really heavy, good value, got slot cards, good circuit boards in there. So these ones are good. don't get as many anymore. What else do I get? Oh, a couple of really big printers. Oh, well, I've got to deal with them. And, oh, got a whole bunch of these iPads. Must be 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 iPads. And they're mostly, they're either 16 gigabytes or 32 gigabytes. So, yeah, so this one's a 32 gigabyte. So not bad. I mean, oh, this one's the broken one. There's another 32 gigabyte. So there we go. Lots of iPads. Nice big Dells. So I'll have to deal with them. Okay, so I'm just going to empty the van out now. And I'll put all these printer boxes inside. And when I start listing on eBay again, I'll put them on eBay. Yeah, so I'm just going to get rid of this. I've got the two big photocopiers that I've got to process and get rid of. Just going to take a couple of boards out. And a lot of this is, I'm just, these all-in-ones, I'm actually going to, I'll put them inside as well. I might have a buyer for them. So resale, iPad resale, all-in-ones resale. So there's not much actually to scrap out apart from the two printers and a couple of UPSs. All right, well, let's get back to the scrap marathon and keep trying to catch up. So I've got this Dell that I want to scrap out. It was from just the recent school pickup that I'd done. I noticed it was red flagged, and the reason is it's got a crack in the screen, and I can't sell. My buyer doesn't buy all-in-one PCs with cracks in the screen. So, well, I want the RAM out of it, because another one that's a good one is missing the RAM. So, yeah, might as well scrap this one out. These all-in-ones. I've gotten the smaller version of the all-in-one Dell a lot of times. This is I'm pretty sure this is the first big one that I've actually scrapped out. Usually they come in good condition, like the other three. I got four of these from that school, so they're all going to be okay to sell. So it's a good opportunity to just scrap it out. I mean, like I said, if this one's still got RAM in it, I can get the RAM. All right. Well, that's quite interesting. Might just zoom in a little bit. I guess with everything, it's just a matter of just getting all the screws that you see. Pretty straightforward. But, I mean, it's an i3. Surprising. I mean, it's Windows 8, so I don't really know why the schools get rid of them so quickly. You would think that they would probably, you know, just pass them on to other schools, but there must be a reason. They just upgrade and yeah, but I can't complain. At least I'm getting stuff. See your DVD. a little power supply unit here. These all-in-ones, I suppose there's everything's inside them, so they've got to compact them pretty well. So I'd imagine the design would be pretty intense at the start, to not only to get it all in, but to make it all functional and try and keep it cool at the same time. So I notice, like, we've got a fan here and a fan on top of the CPU here. I'm just assuming that these would run quite hot. Okay. So I don't need this power supply, so I'll just cut this out. Hey, little power supply. Just sell it as scrap power supplies, I suppose. Now, trying to work out what goes first. Hey, something had to give. All right, quite a odd-shaped motherboard, actually. And here's my little RAM that I want. So what do we got? Yep, 4 GB RAM. This is I'll put this in the other one that I've got, the better one. The only thing with that one was, yeah, I just had one that was missing RAM, so. So instantly I've, you know, increased the value of one with the RAM back in it. Turn it into a good working PC. And even if my buyer doesn't buy these all-in-ones, they're good for me to keep for people that, like friends that need a working PC. And even for me, I always keep a couple spare in my room, just in case my PC breaks down for whatever reason. I mean, it shouldn't, but sometimes it does, or sometimes it's just the monitor might blow, or who knows, you know. And it's really handy to have a spare PC just so I can log on to the internet and stuff like that, to be able to update things or just check an email or whatever I need to do. So that's the good thing about it, so I'm not sort of stressed out trying to replace my PC or anything. Gives me a chance to fix it up. So this is the only thing that seems to be there will be a trick to it, but only having done one, it's not going to give me any clues. But I'll just keep undoing screws until something else gives. Ah, silly me. Someone's probably screaming, the two screws on the top. I just didn't see them. Crazy. Well, that's a chunky piece of steel, actually. Oh, gosh. Oh, well. I've got to get up with the times on these all-in-ones. I'd imagine by next year, these will start coming in real heavily, because a lot of schools seem to be replacing regular PCs and going for either laptops like iMacs and all-in-ones. Which is good for me because more resellable. It's just a 250 gig hard drive. So really, that would be one of the reasons why they've replaced them, but I could easily, in the other ones, like I said, I just keep one for myself in case I need to temporarily use it. So I wouldn't change the hard drive in that, but it might be worth the other ones just putting in a couple of the 4 terabyte hard drives that I've got. And that might spruce it up a bit. All right. So obviously it's got an i3 CPU. It goes as copper aluminium radiator. Just got to remove this steel part if it comes. Yeah. I'll have to get that off later. I'll fix that. So it's an i3. Just give it a bit of a wipe. Yep. The SRORG. Yeah. i3s don't sell that well. Only a few models. So you've got to look it up to see whether it's a good one. People are up to i5s now, but so if they only sell for like $10, I don't bother. If they sell for like $20 or more, then I keep it as a sellable one. Yeah, motherboard is really unusual. Not a great deal on it, but not a lot of rubbish really. You've got the things on top here rather than the side, obviously, because it's an all-in-one. So scrap value, they're really not that heavy, not that much, but they're okay, you know, for what it is. All right, take these little fingers off this board and throw it into mid-grade. So again, with these, I'm not going to bother trying to get out the LCD finger strip boards, because that would mean I'd have to open up a lot more. I'd rather send this off as it is, like this, to not cause any excess mess. So I'd have the finger strip boards up along here, but yeah. I've gotten what I've wanted out of it. There we go, complete. Didn't get much apart from, you know, some scrap value here. The motherboard, hard drive, only 250 gig scrap value. Power supply unit, copper aluminium radiator, and possibly a sellable i3 CPU. Oh, I forgot about my 4 gig of RAM. So that's, you know, pretty good value too, but like I said, I'll use it in the other one. All right, that's that. Let's go on to something else. So the next thing I wanted to get rid of was this kind of vintage fax machine. When it comes to vintage stuff, this is about where I class vintage. I think it might be the 802 fax, something like that. Harris 3M 2110. So quite an old one, a bit busted up. Can't remember where I got this from, but it was just hanging in the garage. So the perfect thing to get rid of first up. So I'll remove some of this plastic. I don't want to open it up too much, because as you can imagine, being a fax machine, it's not going to have a great deal of circuit boards. Most of the stuff in here is all about the, you know, all the workings and all that. So I want to keep it intact so I can get rid of it as scrap metal. But there should be a main. Okay, we've got one circuit board here, and it looks like the main circuit board is under this metal panel. We've got a little power board. Yeah, little couple bits and pieces. So probably not a great deal to it, but I just want to get rid of it and take out the stuff of value for us. Whereas the new style fax machines, or anything like even just 10 years old, they don't have much at all. So, oh, there's a little power board. Can always take off this thing. So, give you an example. If you're just selling power boards as they are, with these transformers, you can see the copper ribbon there. So even if you're just selling transformers, you can remove this copper ribbon, because it's sort of like, it's got tin plating and stuff. I just throw these into brass. They're good enough. And that way you've still got your transformers. So even if you're selling transformers and you see those plates on the real bigger transformers, they can be really thick, nice. You pry them off, cut them out, and you get yourself extra copper or brass. In the big ones, you can put them in as copper. You also got a relay here. You can, got some copper spool in there, and maybe silver contacts. It's up to you whether you take them off or just leave them on the board. That one just pops out. Wires. Yeah, this is just a probably just get away with it being a mid-grade board. It's got some nice gold pins, actually. Might take those off first, and the rest, yeah, just leave it as a mid. Okay. Oh yeah, well, here's a nice board. Wow. For a fax machine, I guess it's right in that nice vintage era. So this is like the RAM board, you know, ROM board, RAM board. And back in those days, they were pretty decent, especially for gold recovery. Nice, just pops out. Yeah, really, really sexy, this. It's got a 3-cell battery here. Wow. Can get rid of our battery. And we've got some 3 ICs, or 4 ICs, and 4 beautiful ceramic EEPROMs. And I'm assuming they'll be, they're not the gold ones. I can't see visible gold in this one. and they all look the same. But yeah, I'm yet to really work out what's in these because I haven't started processing, and I haven't seen anyone that sort of separated the gold to the non-gold. Like, this would most likely be platinum, because back when they made these, platinum was very cheap, so I can't see it being silver. There would be silver in there, no problem, but I'm just guessing that it's platinum instead of gold. It wouldn't be palladium. So, but yeah, that's with all the EEPROMs that you see that you can't see visible gold. And I separate the two because one day I want to work out what actually that is, whether it's silver, whether it's platinum, palladium, or what, or tin, which I doubt. But yeah, really nice. And because they're ceramic, EEPROMs are generally ceramic, so there's going to be bonding wires in there, and I'd imagine, you know, the bonding wires, if they're the same color, then it's definitely going to be something like platinum. But yeah, and there's still the main board here, and actually, you know, this is actually quite nice for those that are into gold recovery. Quite a decent batch of bits. All right, so looks like I'm gonna have to work out how to get this thing off, because there's no screws from the bottom. So we're just gonna have to create some more plastic. This side should do us. There's another board inside there. Just tactile switches. This is a thing with scrapping out just one of things, because you don't have previous notes on how it came apart or what was where. Yeah, it's a lot easier, you know, because I pick up eWaste, I'm getting a lot of the same stuff. So when it comes to scrapping, it's just, it becomes automatic after a while. You know exactly where, which screws to take off, what to, and what to expect where. But this is what makes scrapping fun, is discovering new things to scrap out. Well, if it was just tactile switches, I would put it as low grade, but because it's got some nice IC chips on there, I can throw this into mid-grade now. So still, we got some extra value that I didn't expect. And there's even another board here. Wow, this is loaded with boards. We still haven't got to the main one, I think. Oop. Camera always gets in the way. Oh, well, this is actually not a bad board either. Some huge IC chips here. For me, I'm tempted to just depopulate this board completely rather than sending this off, because they're old vintagey kind of ICs. So I might do a little test. Yeah, just as I thought. Gonna have to sort of semi-sacrifice this just to kind of show you. What you won't see is the all the wires going through that are gold plated. You can see that plate there, it's got gold plating on top of it. Don't know if you could see that, but yeah, when it comes to these vintage ICs, a lot of times they can be really good value for gold. So I'll depopulate this whole thing and I'll just put this away. So when you crumble up ICs like that, sometimes when you're trying to take them off they crumble up, that's fine, just put it with your ICs. It's going to be expected to have crumbled up ICs in your batch, and you know you've already started the process. It just when you go to recover gold, or when someone goes to recover the gold from it, they're going to already have access to the gold. So when it might be like pyrolysis, and so it just makes the process quicker. I don't want to leave that board in there. Yeah. Okay. All right. I think I found the last screw. Inside here. I think we're done. Oh. Looks like there's one more in the middle here somewhere. There we go. That was easy. Oh, there's a nice power board there too. Well, this is absolutely loaded. Yep. Another decent power board with quite a bit of wire we can clean up. We'll take it. There's probably something under there too, like a power supply or something. I can see it's an aluminium casing, so might as well. I'm going to have to pull it apart anyway to get that aluminium. Yeah, another power board in there. Some copper coils or little transformers. And that's aluminium. Another power board there. So, quite a good little... Oh, this is incredible. Gosh, I wish they still made fax machines and stuff like this one. But it just goes to show, like, when you see true vintage stuff like this, as simple as a fax machine, never let them slip, because in a lot of cases they're better than PCs of the same vintage, you know. So, all right. Just gonna undo these wires. And here we have it. And I think, yeah. Okay, so this is your main board here, and it's got a daughter card on top, so it's just going to reveal a lot more nice boards underneath. So, absolutely incredible. Nice little daughter card here. One-sided, still got some really nice gold pins there, and but yeah, all those ICs, they'll be good. There's a few ceramic ones, so the ceramic ones are usually better for gold recovery than the plastic ones. Not always the case, but sometimes if you you break off the top of the ceramic, because there's nothing really in the top section of the ceramic. There we go. And so that's the ceramic there, and there's no bonding wires in amongst that. That's just ceramic. You can throw that out. But you can see the exposed little chip in there. You can see all that gold, right? These are super for gold recovery. I'm guessing, you know, probably... you know, if a regular IC, they average a gram, one to two grams per kilo of ICs. Well, these would average probably about the same, maybe a little bit more, so around 1.5 to 2.5. But it's the thing is that the ceramic weighs a lot heavier than a plastic one, right? So one of these will weigh like 8 of these, so you're getting a lot more gold for individual ceramic ones than you do for the plastic ones. But yeah, beautiful. So you can see, I'm sure you can see all that. And so these two also will be like that, and these plastic ones, they could be anything, but they certainly don't have, like, in amongst what you don't see underneath the sides, there will be bonding wires that lead to every IC, every leg. So there's a lot more than what you just see. That was super. And now this board, well, it's packed. It's, you know, it would go as a server grade board because it doesn't have rubbish. Not necessarily telecom, but definitely a server grade. It's a pretty high grade board because of all those IC chips you see. I don't see any ceramic ones, but that's fine, it doesn't matter. They're all going to be really good. Yep, that's a actually, this little thing here, I think that's a CPU. yeah, this is kind of like a fax version of a motherboard, and I think what we're going to find here is the old school 8080 series. No, sorry, not the 8080, like a Pentium 1 or a Pentium 2 CPU. So this board just gets better and better. If it is a Pentium 1, it's the highest sort of, about the highest by weight value CPU you can get. take off our little pig. Oh yeah, yeah, this is the oh sorry, did I say Pentium 1? I mean 186. Not Pentium 1. 186 and 286 look like that, and this one is a 186. So that's totally unexpected, absolutely beautiful. This is my this is what gets me excited. Aside from Pentium Pro, the next thing is these little ones, because they're only tiny, but look at that. Very nice, very, you know, they're even worth more as collectible than they are as gold recovery. But if you had a pound of these, you'll get really good gold recovery out of them. But oh, so yep, it's definitely a 186, and I'll just check the model number to see, because I've got a few of these, and I'll see if it matches up. If not, I'll keep it in my collection as a different version. But wow, I did not expect a 186 CPU coming out of them. I think I pay about 186, I'm not sure, I think I pay about $300 or $350 per kilo for these, something like that. But yeah, what I've got to do with a lot of the old ceramics now is, rather than doing a per kilo price, just to make it easier for everyone, I'm just going to put individual prices. So I've got to get, well, I've got a set of lab scales, because these only weigh a very tiny amount, so you got to use a calculator, and you put these on a regular scale and they don't even come up, because the scales go in 5 gram increments. So there we go, really nice. Even the socket there for the CPU has got really nice gold pins in there, really awesome. So I thought this scrap was going to take 2 or 3 minutes, and it's probably the best thing I've scrapped in a couple of weeks as far as interesting gold recovery bits. Really awesome. I really didn't expect it, and this thing here, that's a CCD sensor. You can see they're a ceramic with really nice gold legs, this one, and the gold inside there. You get these on a lot of your scanners and copiers, scanner with scanner, or photocopiers with scanner. So yeah, this one, unexpected again, CCD sensor. It's probably the oldest one that I've ever pulled, and very, very, very nice. And these capacitors are very unusual. They're not tantalum, but still unusual. So this board here, because I collect different types of CCD sensors, I just like to keep them. You know, this one, I'll just put this one in my own collection there. Another item that was very unexpected. It's a really nice motor here too, actually two of them. These, hang on, just get up a bit here. They certainly surprised me. I mean, it's probably been a while since I've gotten a fax machine of this vintage. These are really nice motors here. Yeah, it's a Densai stepping motor, so Japanese, and this looks very beautiful actually, and still got the wire on this one intact, so luckily I didn't cut it. I'll keep this. I'll just get this bit of brass off. All right, so this side's kind of done. I'm going to get this motor out. Oh, perfect. Another one. Beautiful. Still got the wires intact. So that's what we want. They're actually slightly different. Yeah, quite different actually. Okay, yeah, both made in Japan, but just different brands. Really nice, two alternatives. Now the rest. Well, we've got more wires leading to somewhere. It's just for the motor that loads the paper, runs the paper through. So aside from the wire and little transformer here, I can call this scrapped. I'll just clean up the wire off camera and I'll throw the rest into scrap steel. But that was the Harris 3M 2110 fax. Wow, that was super intense, totally unexpected. If I could scrap at least one of these kind of things a day, I would have an absolute ball. This would be like paradise for me. This is the reason why I got into scrapping is wasn't really for the money. It's for discovering things and the fun of it. So two really nice Japanese brand stepping motors, beautiful. Our main board, server grade, beautiful board. Don't know, because it's a vintage, I'll probably end up depopulating it rather than selling it. It's even got some, got the nice gold pins in there, pretty much everywhere. So like here, you see the pins and they're not gold. So they're never going to be silver. They'll be tin plated brass or nickel plated brass at best. They're never silver because silver corrodes and you wouldn't get a good contact. I'll save that for later. Beautiful daughter card again. I showed you the ceramic ICs at least with the beautiful gold inside. Can't go wrong with that. The CCD sensor with a whole bunch of ICs that'll go in my collection. Another decent board with really nice big IC chips that we removed one, and I showed you the gold inside there, so they're all going to be good. Just keeps going. Fantastic little board with four EEPROMs and four regular ICs. Again, total depopulation. Get all these ICs, even get these nice gold pins, super gold pins. Look at that. Beautiful. So, one, two, three, four, five. Then we got the two power boards, bit of aluminium, again, bit of low grade value. Another little power board there. And that was the first board that we got. Get away with being a mid-grade, not a lot there for us, apart from getting those gold pins, but still, look at that. And then, to top it all off, did I show you? Yeah, and that one too, also get away with being a mid-grade board. It's mostly a tactile switchboard, but it's got quite a few ICs on it, so that was fantastic. And then the piece de resistance, a 186 CPU. Can't get much better than that. I wish I had a ton of these. If you had a ton of these, you'd be able to buy a small island somewhere off the coast of the Pacific Ocean. awesome. Love it. This goes into my collection. If not, I'd rather sell it than go for the gold recovery, because you don't get many 186s anymore. And there are, you know, still a lot of collectors out there that like that sort of stuff. All right. Well, guys, that was awesome. What next? Who knows? I'm going to need I need a cup of coffee after this. Just have a bit of a break and just look over my stuff. Okay, guys, hope you enjoyed this part of the scrap marathon. Stay tuned for the next series coming up shortly. Thanks for watching. Keep scrapping, and I'll catch you soon.